Should you still consider buying PC games from Steam, even in 2023? And the answer is, yes. You can still absolutely consider buying PC games from Valve's Steam Digital Storefront, as Steam still supports regional pricing for many regions, if not all. Also, due to its proper customer support and ease of refund facility, Steam is still in the top position in the video game distributor market. But recently, Steam has changed their regional pricing policy, considering the present economic situation globally. So due to this, many game publishers, mainly the indie game publishers, have started increasing the prices of their games up to double the amount of their previous prices. Even the regional prices have raised up to almost 500% in some regions, like Turkey. This is especially happening with indie video game publishers, but don't worry guys, even the AAA studios are not behind in this race. Ah well, they're actually doing this since decades now. We have been paying much more amount for AAA games since a long time. Games, which were used to be highly discounted at 80% and 90%, can now be seen going down to 60-70%. Unlike before, many game publishers are now offering lesser discounts on their games if they didn't raise their games' prices after the arrival of Steam's new price policy. Sega already removed their region pricings of the Sonic games in the last year from almost every supported region. Hogwarts Legacy and Elden Ring prices have also went up recently. So yeah, games are becoming more and more expensive, especially after the implementation of Steam's new regional pricing scheme. So, finally let me tell you how you can save more money while buying games from Steam after the price increase. Number 7. Game Bundles. You can save a lot of money when purchasing game bundles of certain franchises, like BioShock the Collection and Batman Arkham Collection, where buying a single game is not worth at all, especially when the games are weirdly priced on the store like this one. But on the other hand, the amount that you are saving buying the bundle varies from one game franchise to another. Take Yakuza Collection for instance, you're only saving 10%, while you are saving much, much more in Batman Arkham Collection. So yeah, if you are saving huge on game bundles, then go for that one, otherwise I would suggest to avoid the game bundles like the Yakuza Collection, where you could buy Yakuza 0 or any other part first if you were not familiar with the series before. Otherwise you might end up never touching the rest of the games from the collection that you have bought if you are not enjoying the first game that you have started playing. Number 6. Wishlist and wait. Search for your favorite games or the ones which you are eager to play the most. Then add the game to your Steam wishlist. For more accessibility, install the Steam mobile app on your Android or iOS device. Now the next time when the game will go on sale, you will get a notification from Steam on both the Steam mobile app and the Steam PC client. You will also receive an email for the same thing. If we see SteamDB's price chart, we can notice that mostly games often goes on sale within a 2-3 months time cycle, but this also varies upon the game and the upcoming major sales. So you can wait for the sale and grab it as soon as it gets available at a discount. Number 5. Sell your inventory items. Now, if you go to your Steam inventory, you might see some Steam trading cards lying there. These cards are used to level up your Steam account quickly, which in return, helps to increase your Steam Friends slot and Profile Showcase slot. But if you're not interested in that, then you should sell those cards to other Steam users in the Steam Marketplace, who might want to get that trading card that you already have in your inventory that you don't want. It will fetch some extra cash to your Steam wallet, which you can use to buy any games and DLCs from Steam. Just remember, friends, to keep an eye on the recent prices at which they were sold recently by other users. It will help other users who are finding such trading cards that they want and that you already have at your Steam inventory, but you have no use of that. So it's a win-win situation here for both of you if you set the accurate price for your Steam trading cards in the Steam Marketplace. Number 4. Check on other platforms. You can check out for games in other platforms or digital storefronts, like GOG and Epic Games Store. Maybe you will get some games at a more discount rate than it is already on Steam. Who knows? There's a chance that it still could happen, right? Also, you can save on Epic Games Store, as they have a reward system for buying games from their store. Number 3. Steam Family Sharing. Now, in some cases, if some or every member of your family play games, and have their own Steam accounts respectively, and say, if one of the members is purchasing a game that any other member in the family already has in his or her Steam library, then I think that it is a waste of money. Steam offers a unique feature which you might already know, but you are still not using it, and that is Steam Family Sharing. By using this Steam's official feature, you can buy a game and share it with your entire family, without giving anyone your Steam login credentials at all. Yeah, it has its own limitations, like you cannot play the same game which any other member is playing at the same time. But hey, it is still a very useful feature that have been into existence since a long time. But don't go beyond that, otherwise you might break up the rule according to the Steam subscriber agreement. Number 2. Buy the Standard Edition. Now there are some games like Lies of P, Mortal Kombat 1, Sonic Frontiers, Gotham Knights, etc., which offers almost useless stuff in a digital deluxe or the non-standard editions of the games. I mean, come on, like, can you explain me what is this? Why would someone even bother to spend extra money on these weird cosmetics, even though the owners of the digital deluxe edition will still have to bear the wound of bad anti-piracy DRMs? Hence, I would suggest you to first clarify whether you really need that extra stuff, and if it is still worth for the extra penny that you're paying. And if not, then stick with the standard edition of the game, unless you're not getting extra story content or major stuff in the deluxe or the ultimate edition of the game. For fighting games, you can always buy the season pass or the DLCs separately later, if you need them. And finally, number 1. Get PC Game Pass. Nowadays, the ultimate way to save hundreds on PC games is by getting a PC Game Pass subscription. Don't worry, Microsoft also provides regional pricing support for its supported regions. Like in my region India, the monthly subscription for PC Game Pass costs around $4.20. You need to pay a rental of $10 a month, and you will get access over 400 games from different genres. Okay, have you caught why I said rental? Well, it is because opting for Game Pass means that you are paying for the Game Pass service and not for the actual games which are there in the service. This is not your game library, rather it is Microsoft's own dynamic game library, which keeps on changing with time. You're not going to own all these games, rather, it is just like you're borrowing games for unknown period of time. So, older games get removed, and new games are added on regular basis. It is like the Netflix or Prime OTT subscription service. So if you have absolutely no problem with it, and you just want to play and enjoy some games, rather than making a huge game collection and keeping 90% of those games in backlog for a longer period of time, then yes, Xbox PC Game Pass will be absolutely worth every penny for you. But remember, friends, that your save files will not be migrated to any other store or platform, except for the Microsoft and the EA titles. And this is where the meaning of, you will own nothing, but you will still be happy, applies in modern gaming. Well, we will talk about that in another video. But for now on, this is how you can still save money on PC games after all these price increases. Now most importantly, there are some mistakes which many users still often make today, but you should not. Like, you should never change or set the region of your Steam profile to any other region where you don't actually live at all. Then, you should never provide your Steam credentials or share your Steam profile with any other person. As I have said earlier, you can use Steam Family Share for that purpose, if both of you live in the same house. Also, you should avoid pre-ordering any upcoming title if it has some huge system requirements. And lastly, don't buy games which you don't want to play. That means, never buy games for the purpose of increasing your game counts of your Steam library, you know, just to show off things and all. No! Just don't do that! It is one of the worst mistakes that a lot of gamers are still making nowadays without realizing that the money could be spent elsewhere, like in groceries, or on those things which you really need, or on those games which you really want to play. But again, this is another topic, on which we will talk later. So that's it for now, friends. I hope that you have enjoyed our video. And don't forget to drop your comments down below, and I will see you in the next video and in this one right here on the screen.